Hi, this is Brian from theunlocker.com, and today we're going to be going over Google TV and showing you how to install third-party applications, or otherwise known as side-loading applications, onto your device. We do have the Android market with the 3.1 update, but it is lacking in some features and, more importantly, in some applications. So we're going to show you some easy ways that you can get the applications you want on your TV. Alright, so before we get started, we need to make sure that our Google TV is set up to allow for non-Android market applications to be installed. You can do this from a couple different screens. If you press the home screen from any screen on your TV, whether you're watching live TV, whether you're in the browser like I am right now, if you press the menu key, you bring up essentially what is your home screen. From there, you can press the menu key and you get various options. One of those options is system settings. I'll show you real quick how you can go into the all applications tab, so basically your app drawer, and if you press menu, you get the same list of available options. What we want to do is we want to go to system settings, and then we're going to go down to applications, select applications, and then that very top one that says unknown sources, we want to make sure that that is indeed checkmarked. If it's not, it's not going to allow you to install applications that do not come from the Android market only. So make sure that's checked, and then we can go on to the next thing. Alright, so the next thing we're going to do is we're going to use the Google Chrome browser, and we're going to go to Dropbox.com. So just go ahead and type that in the menu bar there. That'll go ahead and take us to Dropbox. Now when we get there, you're not going to download from here, although I haven't tried it. You probably could down at the bottom there where it says download Dropbox. You probably could, but I definitely want to show this for people that can just log in from the site. So you can use the web browser and use Dropbox like this, but we're also going to install the application and show you how to use that. Now log in up at the top right. Go ahead and click that. And then they've got a Google TV hacker site that's basically sharing a bunch of files that you can download from their Dropbox account. So to do that, go ahead and type in GTV Market. You want to do @gmail.com. And then hit your tab button. And then the password is capital GTV. 2011. Then go ahead and hit the login. Hit the login button there. Now you're into the Google TV hackers Dropbox account, so to speak. So you can see that there's a lot of different folders here, and one of the folders that we're going to be concentrating on are the APKs confirmed for public GTV 2.0, which is Google TV 2.0, which is the Honeycomb update. And then when you go into that folder, you can see all of these available applications, and you can download and you can install any one of these applications. So we're going to go ahead and we're going to focus on the Dropbox application, and we're going to go ahead and install that. Okay, now once you've clicked on Dropbox and you've downloaded that file, nothing's going to happen. Your system's not automatically going to prompt you to do anything. So from this screen, just press your home button, and then down here, this is your notifications tab. So just like when you're doing something with an Android powered phone or tablet, and you download something, that process is all recorded in your notification. It'll show you while it's downloading, and then once it's downloading, it'll give you a notification showing that it has downloaded successfully. If we go ahead and click on that, and mine's labeled Dropbox-1 because I've actually downloaded this before. But once you get that, go ahead and just click on that. Now that it says download complete, and then it'll take you to a screen that won't look exactly like this because I've already got it installed. But I'll just say okay, and then you'll have this screen come up, which is the package installer. Go ahead and hit install. Dropbox will go ahead, do its normal install, and then from there we can open up our Dropbox program. And then now this gives us a little bit easier access, and you can see, and this is actually my personal Dropbox, it gives you easier access than it does on the web browser. You can certainly use the web browser, but I wouldn't recommend it. All right, so I've gone ahead and I've unlinked my device from Dropbox, so basically I've logged out. So when you first open the Dropbox application, this is the screen you're going to be greeted with. Go ahead and select I'm already a Dropbox user, just like we did on the website, and then we're going to enter in the GTV market at gmail.com. And then we're going to hit our tab key, and the password again is capital GTV2011. Go ahead and hit login. And now you see a much more user-friendly screen, something that would be much easier to see from, say, 10, 15 feet away. So you can come down here. They've got the same folders that they did on the website. So APK is confirmed for public GTV. Go ahead and click on that. You can see here that they've got a lot of applications. Amazon App Store is one of those applications that they've got. You can go ahead and install straight from this screen. I said it a little bit earlier that if you downloaded from, because when we downloaded from the website, we had to go to our notifications, we had to select that download, and then the package installer launched. When you're actually using the Dropbox application to install these apps, you actually don't have to go through all that. So we'll try autotrader.com real quick. Go ahead and download this, and then you'll see that the application or the package installer automatically comes up on its own. So that it's a little bit nicer, a little bit more time friendly. So go ahead and use the Dropbox application. It's better than the website, but we'll go ahead and we'll install that. Then once we do, we'll go ahead and open it and take just a quick peek at it. And you can see autotrader.com is working. And I gotta enter my zip code yet. I really don't want to play with that app, but okay, so we'll come back here, go to our app drawer again. I think I have too many things running in the background right now. Try that again. And here's our app drawer, and you can see now AutoTrader's there. Dropbox is there. Did try that classy fireplace. That's actually from the Android market. But you can see there's a number of things. Astro is not available in the Android market, so that's something that I sideloaded. And right now we're still a little bit limited on what we can sideload, just because, or not what we can sideload, but what we can get from the Android market and what we can get from the Amazon market, for example, because we did download the Amazon market, and this is what it looks like. So if you install the Amazon App Store, here you go. You've got all these various applications, and it looks intuitive enough. It looks like you've got a lot to choose from, but in fact, if you select, like we'll take this tic-tac-toe glow right here, and it's going to come up and tell us that it's not compatible with our device. So, it's not perfect. It's another app store. It's more applications. I'm sure there's more apps that run on this. There's really no way of filtering them out. But if you want to at least go and try to download the free app of the day or something like that, you can do it here. It's not necessarily going to run. But because we have access to sideloading applications and we have GTV hacker site that basically put this together for us, we've got a decent amount of applications here. And you can see a number of them. You know, they've got a chess, a dictionary, docs, Dropbox, of course, ES File Explorer, which I believe that is available in the Android market, Flashlight, which I have no idea why that would be useful, Google Music, that could potentially be useful to you, Ice Cream Sandwich Launcher, that they've also got. They've also got Launcher Pro, and I tried to install Launcher Pro, and maybe it's just because I've got the Google TV or the Sony Google TV up here, and it's if you're familiar with it, you've got the little optical mouse over your right thumb, and while that's perfect for navigation, it's not very friendly when trying to press and hold down a screen as you're flipping through various home screens. Things like playing Angry Birds with this remote would be near impossible because you'd have to, click and then you have to drag across the mouse pad. Well, you really don't have a mouse pad. You've got a little thumb pad here. So, some things are going to be a little bit more difficult to play on this, obviously, than they would be on a phone or a tablet. But you get the idea, and you see the variety of things that you can download and install. There's Skyfire. I can tell you that I did load up Skyfire, the pro version that supports the video playback. And I went to CBS, and I was able to get a video to play. I was not able to get it to play in full screen. It would only play in probably a 3x5-inch screen on my TV. So just a little portion of it. But you could see the full... the full video, the entire camera angle and all that, nothing was cut off. But when you went to full screen, it got all out of whack. So we're still working on trying to find out a fix, because bringing, the CBS, NBC, ABC, Fox, all that content to Google TV is something that I'm sure myself and a number of other people are interested in and really wanting to get working. So where there's a will, there's a way, and especially in the world of Android, if you haven't found out by now, if it can be done, and there's a demand for it, someone out there is going to find a workaround. So, but for right now, you're good to go. You can go ahead and download these applications. You got applications from another source, another Android market you want to install that you use. Go ahead, feel free, play around with it, see what apps work, see what apps don't work for you, and stick around. We'll have the full review on this up. Should be in a couple of days, and you can take a look at that, and hopefully we'll offer some more tips and tricks for you at that point in time that can help enhance your Google TV experience. But this is Brian from theunlocker.com, and we'll see you next time. Thanks.